Okay, now we are going to stand, I'm sorry, we should have said my name standing for the pledge. This week is going to lead us.
Good evening, everyone.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, so at this time, our graduating students have a few words they would like to share. So Malcolm, Alex, and Roger, if you would like, please come forward. Ms. Kelly and Ms. Darga will be coming with them. Ms. Kelly and Ms. Darga are their teachers. Ms. Darga and Ms. Kelly.
All right, so we have our three graduates this year. Roger and Alex have been with us for 7 years, and Malcolm has been a student since 2021. So Mrs. Kelly and I asked our graduates a few questions, and they wanted to share some of their thoughts with you about their years at Jardine. So our first question, what has been your favorite work site that you've gone to over all of the years? So Malcolm, what's been your favorite work site over all of these years?
Detroit Zoo and Good Guess I Can Clean, Disables, Look at Animals.
Alex, what's been your favorite work site?
Which school is Jardine? I also like training. All right. And Roger, what about you? What's been your favorite work site? My favorite work site is the school story. Who's always really busy? All right. Our next question is, which Jardine special activity have you enjoyed the most, Malcolm? Music therapy. I like music therapy because I listen to music and learn folk music.
Alex?
I like playing air hockey. I like to be around.
Our next question. What have you learned from the classes and all of the work sites that you participated in? Malcolm?
I like to draw smart, dress right, be on time, be polite, be friendly, be a team player.
Alex, what about you? What have you learned?
I've learned about not to be a washout.
Roger?
And we're letting all guys in the stock. In the classroom, what about places in our community?
All right. Our next question is. That's our last question. Okay. What are your plans for the future, Malcolm?
Get a paying job, rigging it, and stocking shelves.
All right, Alex. What are your plans?
I plan to work at a car wash at JC.
And Roger, how about you?
Thank you to everyone.
Kobiak and Mrs. Deborah Kobiak. Mr. and Mrs. Kobiak are the parents of Alex Kobiak. Mr. Kobiak has come to share some words to share about Alex's career here at German.
Hello, I'm Jim Kobiak, husband to Deb Kobiak and father to Alex Kobiak. We want to thank Jardim staff and Hazel Park Schools administration for allowing my wife and I to share our thoughts on this special moment. We've all heard the quote, it takes a village to raise a child. It takes many caring people to provide a safe, healthy, and thriving environment for children to grow up happy and successful. However, when you have a special needs child, you need more than a village, which may consist of neighbors, friends, relatives, or coaches. You need an army of highly trained specialists, special education, special forces. There have been many people on this unexpected journey who have helped our son and who have been part of our special forces team. Alice entered early intervention services at age 3 with Royal Oak Schools. And for the past 23 years, the Special Forces team has included 1 school nurse, 2 teacher consultants, 3 directors of special education, 5 speech pathologists, 5 social workers, 5 principals, 5 occupational therapists, 6 transportation staff, 6 psychologists, 6 superintendents, 10 job coaches, 15 paraprofessionals, and 37 teachers. Total of 90 professional staff who have been part of this 23-year journey. In addition to these 90 school staff, there have been countless other private paid professionals such as speech and OT therapists, ASD home-based therapies, and parent support groups. Among the many people who play a very important role in our child's education, and there are a handful of people who stand out as going above and beyond call of duty. One of those individuals is Ann Kelly. Ann, you are an exceptional teacher. You deeply care about your students and our son, and it shows in your actions and words. As a parent, you can always tell when someone truly gets your child, when someone understands their unique traits and needs. And Ann, you have done this. And you have devoted time, effort, and attention to understanding his needs and helping him succeed. Most importantly, you placed a priority on developing a positive relationship and connection with our son. Thank you, Anne, for all you've done for our son. Your sense of humor, compassion, problem-solving skills, and dedication made his experience at Jardim truly enriching. You have our deepest respect and gratitude. Thank you to all Jardim staff. Sorry. It has not escaped us for a single moment the amount of effort and dedication it takes to be an educator in the special education field. When we sent him to school each day on the bus, we knew that he would be safe and cared for by caring people. We are so grateful for the many enriching work experiences available to him at Jardim. We are also grateful for the very relevant curriculum used at Jardim, unique learning systems which focused on relevant life skills for his future. The community-based instruction was often the highlight of his day. When he arrived home from school, he would often repeat to us things he learned at school or did at school. The curriculum and experience had an impact and meaning for him. Alex has enjoyed the many inclusive social events hosted at Jardim. He has enjoyed his classmates, who have been supportive, kind, and welcoming to our son. Alex, we are so very proud of you. We are so glad you are our son. You have been our greatest teacher. We look forward to your future and journey ahead. We love you. Congratulations on your graduation.
Certificate presentation, which will be done by Mr. Darden and Ms. Angel.
our baseball bat.
Sorry, that's hard to follow. Okay. So our first graduate that I'm going to talk about is Malcolm Campbell. Malcolm has been a student at Vernon for 2 years, and he's been in my class for the past year. I'm so glad that I had a chance to get to know Malcolm this past year. His bright smile, his kind heart, and his quiet voice. Malcolm has made good friends at Jardon, and he's grown into a valuable employee at the Detroit Zoo in Burlington. Malcolm loves music and boxing. When we go into the activity room, Malcolm will usually immediately go to the boxing glove, get the boxing gloves on, and get his workout on the punching bag. And Malcolm knows what he's doing. He knows the correct stance, and he knows the moves to do. I'm so proud of Malcolm, and I look forward to hearing about his successes in the future. So we're going to give the certificate of completion and the Boxer Award to Malcolm Campbell.
You grow, make friends, and try out new activities, even when you don't want to. Well, you know, may not always want to, but to participate, but with time and understanding, you would come around. I will truly miss you, Alex. And now for the other award, that leadership certificate, what a kind person you are. The award that he gets, he's a young man who loves to play games. He loves to play cards, checkers, chess, just a few. Obviously, air hockey. He does love the activity room. Alex, at first, you know, what he's really learned to do is ask others to join him. You know, when he first started here, he would never do that. Right? You have friends, right? And you can ask him to play games. And so Alex is a very good sport also. You know, he lets his friends win. I mean, not lets them win. When they win, he doesn't get angry or upset. Cheers him on. At bowling today was a perfect example. It came down, he finished first, and he came down to another lane and was cheering his friends on for bowling. So Alex, you receive not only the certificate of completion for your Jardon, but you also receive the Fun and Games Award.
Roger developed friendships in class and work as a team member with his co-workers, especially in the Jardon School store. Roger likes to be neat and organized, and I appreciate those qualities because I am the same way. Roger loves everything about sports. He can recite the game schedule for the coming weekend and tell you all the winners and losers on Monday. Roger loves movies, and he can tell you when a movie will open, even if it is weeks or months away. And the students in my class know Roger is their puzzle maker. Over the years, he's made more than 136 puzzles, and we have the photos on our iPad to prove it. I know that Roger will be a valuable employee and a participating man that he has become. So the certificate of completion and puzzle award goes to Roger Dawn.
Brian Paul Smith was a graduate of Jardine's 1988 graduating class. 2 months before Brian graduated, he inexplicably passed away in his sleep. Brian exemplified character qualities of kindness, happiness, helpfulness, and unselfishness. When one was around Brian, he made them feel happy. Brian was always willing to lend a helping hand, often without being asked, empathizing for those around him and engaging others in conversation. There were times when a nod of the head was all that was needed to let you know you were significant and cared for by Brian. He was the person that opened a door for you without knowing you. In 1989, a year after Brian passed, his parents established a financial gift and recognition for graduating students from Jardine. This will be the 34th year the award has been given out. Brian's family has been present at the Jardine graduation every year. It is with great honor the Brian Smith Humanitarian Award be given to these two young men who exemplify many of the characteristics this award represents. I am pleased to announce the recipient of the 2022-23 Brian Smith Humanitarian Award is Malcolm Campbell and Alex Cody.
So I won't keep the graduates up here too long. Roger, we love you too. But, by the way, I have to say this. For those quiet, spoken, understated people, you have a lot of power. And I want to just emphasize the fact that my brother was an individual that he could light up a room without even saying too many words. He would hold the door open for people. He would just do things that you wouldn't expect. And the only thing that I would want to try and invoke to the graduates, and congratulations, everyone. Thank you, administrators, teachers, graduates, and the parents, is that maybe think about putting your phone down. live in the present, please. And just think about the people that are around you. That's the most important thing. And if you can do that, then things will come back to you. And I know that everyone here recognizes that, and that'll happen. So at any rate, it's my pleasure to be here once again. Every year I do this, and it's an honor to have my brother memorialized and to see everyone here. And what can I say? I'm just so proud of everyone here, and it's a community effort. And I want to thank everyone. Oh, and the little financial award, that's something my parents did. I try and keep that going. And by the way, you don't have to be rich or anything like that to confer to people a sense of good and well-being. I'm not going to get overly scripture on you because I'm not good at that, but those that maybe have not as much but can give of themselves as they go, that's some of the more poignant things that you can do rather than having. You see a lot of people, and they give money out, they give charity and things like that, and they kind of put their chest out there and wear a proud banner. But those that are a little bit understated and can hold the door open, smile, and give
someone a notion of goodwill. That's where some grace is at. So thank you, everyone.
It is with great honor that I recommend this young gentleman for the Vocational Achievement Award for the class of 2023. This young man has consistently strived to do his personal best at every job he has been placed in. He is eager to work and knows his job duties well, often not having to be prompted to do his task. He is polite and cooperative. He follows directions, uses his time well, and has excellent attendance. At his final assessment for Michigan Rehabilitation Services, his job coach writes, "Roger continues to show excellent work habits. He is focused and disciplined. He makes good use of his time. He shows good attention to detail. He is respectful and responsive and makes a good faith effort to do as asked. He does not complain or get distracted, and he shows an overall positive and upbeat attitude. I am pleased to announce the Vocational Achievement Award for the class of 2023 is Roger Dawn."
Congratulations.